Hey guys, welcome back to another video. If you're new here, welcome. So in today's video, we're gonna be making these watermelon lip glosses. So if you're interested in watching that, stay tuned. Okay, so you always wanna start off by sanitizing your work area, and I'm gonna use our Lysol all-purpose cleaner. We put on our gloves. Okay, so for this lip gloss, we're gonna need two bowls. We're gonna be using avocado oil, castor oil, coconut oil, and vitamin E oil. Now I'm gonna grab my colors. So I'm gonna be using, for the green, I'm gonna use yellow and blue one from TKB Trading. And then for the red, I'm gonna be using red 21. And then of course, our flavoring oil is gonna be watermelon from Lorraine Oils. All right, so let's start off by making the green first. So I think I'm gonna start differently, because usually I add the VersaGel first and then I add the oils and the color. But this time, since I've never done green before and we have to mix two colors, I think I'm gonna add the colors first and the oils. So I'm gonna do the oils and colors first, and then I'm gonna add the VersaGel and see how that works. Okay, so we're gonna start off with the oils first. So I usually use 1 teaspoon when I make my regular lip glosses, but since I'm gonna be using less VersaGel for this one, I'm gonna be using the 1.5 teaspoon. All right, starting off with avocado oil, castor oil, coconut oil, and vitamin E oil. So I've never done this before, so I'm just gonna add a drop of this blue. I don't want it to be too much. And then we'll just see where it takes us. And then basically we're gonna add probably 2 drops of this yellow. Okay, now we mix. Okay, that looks pretty good actually. I might add just another drop of each, because I feel like once we put the VersaGel in, it's not gonna be as pigmented. So I think I'm gonna just add a drop of each. It honestly looks way darker on camera and more blue on camera than it does in person. I think this is good, honestly. I think this is perfect. So let's add it to the VersaGel. Grabbing our VersaGel from TKB Trading. I'm finally almost out of this bad boy. This one was 3.5 pounds. Okay, I'm just gonna do a little bit, because like I said, I don't want that much. I mean, we don't need that much green. All right, I zoomed you guys in just a little bit so you can have a better view. And I'm gonna add this green to it. Oh, that's cool. Let's mix. Honestly, I think it looks perfect. You see the green on here? I think it looks good, guys. What do you think? I mean, you can't tell me, but you can always write it down in the comments below, but I think this is what I'm gonna go with. All right, so now we're gonna add the watermelon flavoring oil. So I'm a little bit scared to add this, because you see it's like a red. So I'm afraid it's gonna leave like a tint or like change the color a little bit, and I hope not. So let's pray for the, I think it's gonna change the color, guys. No way, that is so sad. Okay, I think I could fix it though. Why does it look so bad on camera? It doesn't look that bad in person. It just looks like a rotten like green. All right, we're gonna fix this. Guys, I'm so sad. I tried to fix it, but I think I'm just making it worse at this point. It just looks like a freaking rotten fruit. A rotten watermelon has been sitting out forever. So I think I'm gonna have to start over. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use my strawberry flavoring and just put a little bit of it, because that flavoring is clear. So just so it could have a little bit of a scent. But either way, I'm only gonna use a little bit of green. So I don't think it's gonna really matter if I put like strawberry flavoring, because the red and with the watermelon flavoring is gonna overtake the strawberry. So I think that's what I'm gonna do, because I missed this. I'm glad you guys got to see it so you don't make the same mistake I did. Look at the difference. This looks even like black on camera, like a brown black. But this is the new one I just made. So honestly, I went with, I decided to go with the mixed berry flavoring oil because I feel like that's the closest to watermelon rather than strawberry. So you see, it's like pretty clear, so it's not gonna do anything. So we're gonna add a couple drops of that. I think that's good, and then we'll mix it up. Okay, and this is how it looks. So now I can throw this away, which I'm so sad about because I hate wasting product, but you know, it happens, trial and error. Okay, we can put this to the side and we'll start on the red portion of it. Get my Risa gel again. And this time we're gonna add a little bit more since this is gonna be the main color for the lip gloss. Okay, and I think that is good. This is how much Risa gel compared to this. It looks the same, but I promise you guys, this is way more. Let's add the oils. I'm gonna be using 1 teaspoon this time since there's more Risa gel. Okay, now that the oils are added, I'm gonna go ahead and add the flavoring oil and the color, and we'll mix it all at the same time. Then we're gonna add our color. So I always add a lot because I love my lip glosses to be pigmented, or as pigmented as they can be. Well, look at that. So I always add a lot of liquid pigment. Whoa, guys, it looks so cool. Look at how it looks. It looks so good. Look at that zoom in. So I don't know if you guys can tell, right? But when you pull it, you can still see that there's some clear in it, and I don't like it. Like, I don't like when you can see like a little clear. Like, I feel like that's not, you know, that pigmented. So I'm gonna add a little bit more of the color, and then I think we'll start filling our tubes. Okay, so before I forget, I also wanna add these little watermelon. I'm gonna use this to scoop it up. Okay, let's grab our syringes. We're gonna need 2 for this one since we have 2 different colors. Let's start off with the green. So I wanted to have a little mini chit chat with you guys, talk to you guys a little bit about life. I know it's been a while since I've talked about my life and what's going on. So I recently quit my job that I've been working at for 3 years, and honestly, it's been a long time coming. Like, I've been wanting to leave that place for so long, but obviously, you know, I stayed because I got bills to pay. But yeah, so I recently just did that, like a week ago. I just quit. Like, one day I was just like, I can't. Like, I feel like that place, oh well, I don't even know if it's the place, but I was just in such a negative mindset, and I felt like I was depressed working there. Like, I wasn't happy, and I was working at nights too, so I was tired all the time. My sleeping schedule was messed up. I was angry, grumpy because of that. So it affected me in a lot of ways. So I just decided one day that I wasn't gonna go back. I didn't tell anybody, or I didn't tell like my parents or anybody. I just left. I don't know though, like, I just felt like everything was gonna be okay, because honestly, like, I didn't plan it. Like, I just woke up one day and I was like, I'm not going to work. Like, I can't do it anymore. It's too much, and it's taken too much from me. Like, it drained me so much. So I've been applying at other jobs, and I just got an interview scheduled for tomorrow. So I'm hoping that I get that job because they pay way better. The times are way better. It's actually in the morning, and it's gonna be Monday through Friday. So I think it's gonna work better with everything that I want to do, with doing this, and hopefully my sleep schedule goes back on track. And yeah, but I don't know, I had a feeling that everything was gonna be okay, and that, you know, I was gonna get a new job and everything was gonna work out the way it's supposed to work out. So I've been trying to focus more on my business this past week that I haven't been working. Oh, so we're gonna take the pipette and cut the top and bottom of the pipettes. But yeah, I've just been trying to focus more on my business. Like, if you follow us on Instagram at RaynaBeautyUS, you'll notice that I've been posting more, and I've been trying to post stories more and just videos. Now we're gonna attach it to the syringe. But yeah, so it's given me some time to work on my business because I've been so drained from that job that I wasn't really motivated, and because I was such, like, in a such, I can't even speak. Because I was such like in a because I was in a negative mindset, I wasn't really doing the things I wanted to do, you know? So right now I'm feeling so much better, like a relief is like off my shoulders, you know? So yeah, so I've been feeling way better. I've been getting more sleep, and I've been feeling more positive. I've been trying to stay positive, and because honestly I was getting a little bit nervous because I was applying to so many jobs and no one was getting back to me, so I was getting a little bit nervous, but I wasn't like, I didn't want to let it get to me because I was like, this is the decision that I made. So I need to be okay with it. I need to be okay with, you know, jobs not getting back to me. Like, I didn't want to let it get to me, you know? Like, I didn't want to put myself back to where I was. So I was just patient, and now I have an interview tomorrow, so wish me luck, you know, I hope I get it. But yeah, let's fill up some lip gloss tubes. So I'm only gonna fill in a little bit. Let's get the camera to focus on the bottom. So let's see, I'm not gonna do that much. I'm wondering, I think that's good. Yeah, I think that's good. That's perfect, actually. Okay, and then let's get the red and top it off. So I don't want it to mix, so that's why I'm trying to put it. Oh, I'm sad. The watermelons got stuck. Ooh, I like how it's looking. So as you can see, the watermelon slices got stuck right there, which honestly, I knew was gonna happen because I saw how big they were. So honestly, I'm not sure what to do. I think I'm gonna just do it without the watermelons because I'm trying to think positive. But yeah, so how have you guys been doing? How's everything in your life? I hope all is well for everybody. Let me know down in the comments below how you guys are. And I want to thank you guys again for supporting me still. We're almost at 500 subscribers, guys. So if you're not subscribed yet, please subscribe. Like, we're about to hit 500 and we're going to be doing a giveaway once we hit 500. I honestly need to make a separate video on that to show you guys what I'm going to be giving away. So I think that's probably going to be the next video. Okay, so I ended up filling the rest off camera, and I still got a little bit more to go. This is just 4, but I think I could fill about 8 squeeze tubes with that amount of lip gloss I made. But this is how it looks. Honestly, I love it. It gives me watermelon vibes. I wish we could have had the watermelon slices in the tube, but it's okay. It still looks good. Let me know what you guys think. I honestly love it. So we're going to end the video right here. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and if you did, please leave a like. Comment down below if you enjoyed this video. And remember to subscribe. Our next video is going to be about our giveaway. I'm going to be letting you guys know what I'm giving away and how the giveaway is going to be set up and everything like that. So stay tuned for that video. But yeah, thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.